Welcome back, y'all. In this video, we're going to talk about how to save time when defining row vectors. The previous video, we saw how to use an entry by entry definition of a row vector, which made our little fingers work extra hard on the keyboard. Let's take a look at an example of code that we wrote in that previous video. Here, we were going to define a vector t, which was 2, 4, 6, 8, who do we appreciate? A 5x1 vector. So T is a 5x1. Notice that I actually had to type all of those in. Instead of having to define row vectors entry by entry, we're going to use what we call colon notation. If we go up to the help documentation and type in colon, and then go ahead and find that first entry, MATLAB will produce for us some syntax on this. Notice that we have these different uses of the colon notation. This is an overloaded operator because we can use it in many instances. This video is about the first two instances, how to use colon to define row vectors. I would encourage you all at home to read these descriptions and take a look at the examples. We're actually going to work through this as a team, but the point of this is you actually don't need me to tell you this. You can read the documentation on your own. The reason I say this is one of my themes in this class is I want you to learn how to teach yourself programming. Regardless, in the early stage, it is helpful to have somebody that's done this before walk you through it. So let's go ahead and create that same vector t using colon notation. In this situation, we'll say that t starts at 2, goes up to 10, and the increment that we go up from 2 to 10 is 2. So if I define that vector 2:2:10, this tells MATLAB, please start at 2, go up in increments of 2, and let the upper bound for the largest element be 10. When I push enter on this, notice that MATLAB produces the exact same vector that I did previously, but I didn't have to write all of it. Let's try yet a second example using colon notation. Here we'll define x, and we'll see if we can figure out what this does. Let's go with the leftmost entry as 2. We'll say that it goes down by -1, and we'll bound the rightmost entry below, in this case, by -2. Can you guess what this vector is? You got it. That started at 2, 1, 0, -1, 2, because I said let the leftmost entry be 2. Let this thing be -1, so let each one go down by -1, and we'll let the rightmost entry, in this case, be bounded below by -2. If I were to switch that middle entry to -2, notice that I'm gonna start at 2, and then I go down by -2 each time. The same thing is true if I go by -0.5, larger vector because my step size is smaller. Let's do this in colon notation at yet a third example. In this case, we're going to do something kind of interesting and actually try to break MATLAB. Specifically, let's define a row vector where the upper bound or the right entry after the second colon is not equally spaced using the step size that we've defined. In this case, we know that the leftmost entry of this vector is going to be 0, then the next one's going to be 0.3, 0.6, 0.9. The question is, what is the rightmost entry of this vector if this 1 is not equal to the 0.9 that we expect? Notice when we push enter here, MATLAB starts the vector at the number on the left of the first colon. Then it will add to that number multiples of the step size until it gets to the largest multiple that is less than the right-hand bound. In this case, we're using the colon operator to do this call. So it says that x is equal to j:i:k. This creates what they call a regularly spaced vector, x, using I as the increment between elements. So in other words, when we're creating this vector, we notice that each element is exactly 0.3 units away from its adjacent elements. Notice that the documentation is trying to capture what's happening. The vector elements are roughly equal to start at j, so whatever's the leftmost portion of this column is j, and then go up to j plus I, j plus 2 times I, j plus 3 times I, all the way up to what they call j plus m times I, and then it gives an actual equation for what m is. It says that m is equal to some function called fix of the equation k minus j divided by I. Well, not really sure what fix does, so let's go ahead and look at the help documentation for that function. So let's go ahead and click fix. Notice that this says is it round toward 0. So the syntax for this is y equals fix of x. The description says that y equals fix of x rounds each element of a vector x towards zero. This operation effectively truncates a number x to an integer by removing the decimal portion of each one. So for positive, this behaves as floor. For negative, it behaves as ceiling. Those are two different functions if you've seen discrete math. Let's see if we can understand what that means. Let's define x to be a vector. I don't know. We'll start at 1 and we'll go up by values of 0.2. And we'll continue to go all the way up to, let's say, 2. So x is this vector. Let's go ahead and type fix of x and see what happens. Notice what MATLAB did is it took everything above the value 1 and it rounded it towards 0. Let's try another example to figure out how the function fix works. We'll define a column vector y that first entry is negative 1.4, second entry is 1.5, third entry is negative 3.2, fourth entry is 4.5, 6.1, and then the last entry is negative 0.3. Let's push enter on that and see that we have this. Recall that MATLAB is claiming that the function fix rounds each element toward zero. Let's go back here. Here, if I take negative 1.4, if I wanted to get closer to zero, I would go up on the number line. In other words, this would get rounded towards negative 1, since negative 1.4 is less than negative 1, which is closer to 0. So my guess is that when I run fix of y, the first element is going to go to negative 1. The second element is positive, so if I wanted to go towards 0, I would actually go down to 1. The third element is negative, so I would go up. In this case, I would guess I would go to negative 3. Fourth element is going to go to 4. Fifth element to 6. Sixth element, I would suppose, goes to zero. So let's go ahead and do fix of y. Notice my guess actually confirms exactly what I thought it would. If it's negative, it goes up to the next highest number. In other words, it's the ceiling of that number. If it's positive, it goes down. Now that we have a sense of what fix does, let's go back to colon notation. The claim on the notation that we focused in on when I go j colon I colon k, k may not be the upper bound value. In fact, MATLAB is giving me an exact entry for that right here. We've actually seen an example of this. If I started at 0, went up by 0.3, and then went all the way up to 1. In this case, j was 0, I was 0.3, and k was 1. Then when we said j, I, k, the claim is that we went up by increments of I all the way until we got as large as possible, but still less than or equal to k. Notice we can actually study that formula that MATLAB is claiming here. Let's go ahead and pull that here. So one thing that I'm going to do is kind of isolate this. We'll go ahead and execute that. Notice that it's saying that the number of increments of I that are available for this call are 3 of them. Let's look at the inside of this. So I'm going to take k minus j divided by I. Well, in this case, k was 1, j was 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. And then I'm going to divide that by 0.3. So 1 divided by 0.3 is actually 3.333333. And then when I run the fix on that number, I'm going to round towards 0, which means I'm going to take the last part of this and round down. In other words, MATLAB is saying when I do the call 0.321, that is equivalent to defining a vector where I start at 0, then I go 0 plus 1 times 0.3, then I go 0 plus 2 times 0.3, and then I go to the last one, 0 plus 3 times 0.3. That is the exact same vector that I get when I call this. This formula that MATLAB is claiming in its documentation is basically telling me how many copies of the increment can I add to the first element of my vector and still say less than or equal to the value of k on the right-hand side of the last colon. I'm going to stop here. For those of you that want to explore more on this on your own, please do so. The reason that I'm highlighting this is when reading documentation, we have to have our thinking caps on. There's more in this documentation about floating point arithmetic. We are not there yet in this class, though we will get there. I did want to call out the general notation. We use this colon notation to create regularly spaced vectors where the increment of increase is defined by the letter I in this notation. This will always produce a row vector. So the left-hand side we say is a row vector. becomes J colon I colon K. Please start that row vector at J. Add to J multiples of I until you get as large as possible, but still less than or equal to the value of K on the right-hand side. Let's take a look at how to store years. So remember in previous videos, we started at 1994, went up by ones, and went all the way to 1998, I believe. So there's a 5 by 1. We could also have gone up to 2021, but gone by twos, and that would produce a row vector of that flavor. The other thing that I wanted to say is we can define row vectors without having to define the increment. If I do not write the I in between, so when I write year becomes 1994:1998, MATLAB will automatically by default interpret the increment to be 1. In other words, if I use this colon notation to create a vector and I do not specifically tell MATLAB the value of I that I want, by default MATLAB will use 1. Let's pretend that I was going to go 2000 to 2010. I have not immediately told MATLAB that I wanted a specific increment value. MATLAB interprets that as wanting the value 1. If, on the other hand, I wanted to go up by increments of 3 years, I simply tell MATLAB, start at 2000, go up by increments of 3 years, and make sure that the last element is no larger than 2010. That's exactly what I've done in that call. A few last notes on how to use colon notation to define row vectors. If I tell MATLAB to start at 2000 and go down by increments of negative 10 all the way down to 1900, I can use a negative increment value to define that row vector. However, if I tell MATLAB to start at 2000, go down by negative 10, and go up to 2200, this is an empty vector because remember, MATLAB starts at the J value, the one to the left of the first colon, and then regularly spaces the elements of this vector until the last entry is as large as possible, but still less than the K value to the rightmost entry in this notation. Well, in this case, I start at 2000, I wanna go down by negative 10s, and the upper bound is 2200. That doesn't make any sense. I can't increment a regular spaced vector that starts at a lower bound of 2000 and an upper bound of 2200, but goes down by negative 10. MATLAB returns an empty vector. In other words, no information can be stored because this is a nonsense call. That leads us into our community challenge for today. In the comment section below, post examples of cool things that you can do with this notation. I'll show you one such example. Let's suppose that I wanted to get the first few odd numbers. So we'll go from 1 to 21 by increments of 2. And then we'll also define a vector y that goes from 2 to 22 by increments of 2. If I did x plus y, that would give me numbers that are spaced by 4, starting at 3 and going up to 43. If I do y minus x, notice I get all 1s. If I do x plus y minus y minus x, notice that gives me numbers starting at 2 go up by 4 all the way to 42. Of course, I could define the same vector 2 going up by 4s and going up to 42, but the point of the matter is with just a little bit of work, all of a sudden I can do some really, really interesting discrete mathematics. My challenge to you all is come up with some fun ideas of how to use colon notation to do something interesting and then share it with our community. Of course, you're always also welcome to post your questions. I grow when you all give me feedback. Thank you so much for your attention, and I'll see you in the next video.